So we have with us today Mr. Stephen Conley of SES Networks, and I'm going to let him talk us through the company and its main activities for those of you who aren't familiar with it.
Yeah, so SES Networks are largest satellite-enabled data connectivity player in the global market. So we've been doing satellite communications as a staple part of our business for the best part of 40 years. SES Networks have a dual constellation, MEO and geostationary satellites. So there's a unique advantage in low latency, enabling applications that previously haven't been able to be used by satellite services. This is a unique advantage that we have over the entire industry, and we're taking that to market strongly, and taking advantage of the benefits of this. But ultimately, for high-speed global managed data connectivity to the maritime environment, SES Networks are completely there and ready to take your business.
Okay. In terms of penetration in the maritime market, how would you say you are doing right now? In terms of penetration, yeah.
So we've been in the maritime market for a long time. What's new to the maritime market for us is a managed end-to-end service. Mm-hmm. We've been incredibly successful in particularly the high-end market. So when it comes to cruise line operations, we've taken a major share in that market. The reason being our unique capability to serve high throughput solutions with low latency and managing the unique
requirements, let's say.
The unique applications that are coming from the cruise market. So there's things from MSC to me, Carnival Medallion, there's smart ship operations that are coming to the market with, you know, huge aggression. It's all about the customer experience from end to end. And from the minute you book your cruise line to the moment you leave, everything is a smooth operation. And that's enabled by the SES Networks platform.
Which are the main challenges at the moment for you, for your company, and other companies in this domain? For instance, is cybersecurity an issue? Do you see other main problems arising in the future from the evolution of technology?
The cost of not looking after your cybersecurity is huge. Nobody wants to think about the effects of that. So absolutely, that's huge on our platform. It's huge in our company in general. Internally, we need to look after it. Our satellites are secure, our platform is secure, and we need to make sure that we push that through the market.
All right. And in terms of your Greek market share, or the efforts to penetrate the Greek market, how difficult do you think this is, given that Greek owners are famous for their negotiation skills?
They are famous for the negotiation skills, so we're happy with that. Flexibility is a main advantage of ours, so we like the challenge that the Greeks offer us. So it's the biggest shipping country, so we are absolutely focused. We've got people on the ground here in Athens who are looking after the customers, understanding requirements, bringing new products for those specific requirements to the market. And I think that's something that's been perhaps overlooked in the past, and we're absolutely focused on Greece as a primary market in maritime, and obviously taking care of that.
Okay. In terms of your clients here, which types of companies are they most active in? In which markets are they most active in? Bulkers, tankers?
So I think we have the broad range, to be honest. Here today, dry cargo is kind of the largest that I've been speaking to today. But to be honest, we've got solutions for everybody. I think there are huge differences in the data requirements, particularly driven just now a lot by the crew. So crew retention is pretty high on the radar for us. We're aware that companies are losing out due to poor connectivity, and we want to enable a good level of welfare for the
So this is a major shift in terms of the way the market works with regards to the previous years, since we are seeing that crews are more and more demanding in terms of their connectivity requirements, and they are pushing owners to adapt, right?
Absolutely. So owners are being pushed to not only look after the effective operations and efficient operations of the vessels, but also take care of the crew welfare side of the house. So we have to be absolutely focused on both pieces here. Operations and reducing costs through the multitude of sensoring that's coming into the market. So these ships are smart ships. We're building smart ships. There's a huge reliance on the sensoring and the ability to bring that back to the shore. We need to be able to do more from the shore in terms of operations. So taking things from shore, ship to shore.
And this is the main trend moving forward, right?
That's a huge trend, absolutely. I mean, digitalization in general, it's a huge buzzword, but it's real. And if you don't embrace it right now, then it's going to be far too late. It's already too late, to be honest. So we're trying to educate the customers basically in a consultation fashion. SES Networks can be a consultant to help the maritime industry understand what digitalization means for their business and how to embrace it and empower themselves to make things better, reduce costs, and improve operational efficiency.
Thank you very much.